Intel is the market leader in what's called integrated graphics. And that's graphics that are integrated into the SoC in notebooks or desktop. And it's really been AMD and NVIDIA who have been pushing discrete graphics for forever. But black and white, Intel is now in the discrete graphics market. And this week it announced ARC 3, 5, and 7 for mobile. And that's not for smartphones mobile, that's for notebook. So I think it's been since 1998. I'm gonna have to go double check with the i740. They brought out their last discrete, but I want to, you know, instead of getting into the nuts and the bolts of the technology, because what I've seen is at least for ARC 3, which announces today, and then ARC 5 and 7 available early summer of this year, which I believe is a push out of that. I thought they were all coming here. There's no other way to look at this other than positive, right? There's very few black and whites that us analysts can put our hats on, or for that matter, even retail investors or people like that. But this is a black and white, right? One day Intel isn't in the discrete graphics market, and now it is. And I think that's the thing that should be focused on. And the 357 is exactly what you would expect, right? Different tiers of performance. And power draw. Intel is calling ARC 3 enhanced gaming, ARC 5 advanced gaming, not to be confused with enhanced gaming, and then ARC 7 for high performance gaming. We really don't have any of the deets on 5 or 7. Looks like OEM support is pretty strong. At least the ones that we were briefed under NDA, it looks like the leader SKU is a design from Samsung that was announced at CES 2022. It's called the Galaxy Book 2 Pro. The final thing that I want to talk about is looking at the future, right? There are a lot of interesting things you can do when you have access to the CPU and the GPU, and you fund most of these notebook designs, which unlike AMD, Intel does more than anybody. And there are some interesting things you can do with power. There are some interesting things you can do with actually sharing performance between the iGPU and the discrete ARC GPU. So, you know, I think that's really what I'm looking at is, can Intel do what AMD can't by integrating the CPU and the GPU?
Yeah, first of all, this was a big announcement. We've all been sort of waiting on the edge of our seats to see, can Intel come into this space? Can they not only enter it, can they be good at it? Intel's been under a lot of pressure across the business to grow, to diversify. We heard at Investor Day, Pat Gelsinger, not Pat Moorhead, although both of you are semiconductor bulls, seemed very optimistic that the ARC business would be important and meaningful and somewhat a quick trajectory to get into the billions of dollars of revenue for Intel. Of course, gaming is an opportunity. I do think Intel's always had on the desktop side some pretty strong support in specific areas related to GPUs, but on the PC, laptops, it's been slow, and this is what we've been waiting for. So the gaming is going to be an area we're going to have to watch closely to see if they can enter, if they can compete, if they can be successful. Of course, with their relationships and the OEMs, they will get SKUs that will be inclusive of their new ARC GPUs, and that will be a great way to get into it. We've already seen Samsung, Acer, Dell, Lenovo all are making commitments to play in this space. As they go up the stream with ARC 5 and ARC 7, will those provide more of a strength and competition to the AMD and NVIDIA, SKUs. Remember, those companies, it's not just about the technology. It's like a religion. And so that's going to be the real question is, you know, will Intel be able to find religion within that gaming community? Another couple interesting things, though, Pat, that is probably worth mentioning is there is an opportunity for growth in this space that isn't just related to gaming. You know, growth related to data and analytics. You know, in Mike Diamond's research note from our team, he put it out. He basically talked about the mathematicians, statisticians, and how fast that business is growing. 3D sensing technologies for LiDAR, for instance, and how much that is growing. All of these are going to be key areas for GPUs, and they're markets where Intel could potentially use its strength to enter to sell more volume. So, you know, it's early days, Pat, but you know, I think it's said that the company's aiming to ship like about 4 million discrete GPUs in February alone. So there's an opportunity to move. It's going to be competitive. This is one that we're going to have to come back to and say, did the company execute? I'm more confident than I've been in a long time in Intel under Pat Gelsinger's leadership. But it's going to be very, very tough sledding. But I'm optimistic. So I'll leave it there.
No, those were good adders. And I think people too quickly forget the new businesses that Intel is getting into. And you know, quite frankly, with the supply at the level they're at, they're going to sell everyone that they can make. It's key for them to stick their positioning, though, in gaming.